Good afternoon, and welcome to the ILFMA Farmers Market Master Series webinar, Social Media for Farmers Markets, Course 3, The Power of Video in Reels, sponsored by the Illinois Farm Bureau. My name is Deborah Cavanaugh Grant, and I am an ILFMA board member, secretary, and chair of the Education Committee. Today, ILFMA welcomes Jennifer Newell, digital marketing specialist who will discuss how to use your smartphone to create video content for your social media channels, including Instagram Reels. Jennifer is a digital marketing specialist located in Central Illinois, representing businesses across the state. She loves helping small businesses thrive in today's market. I have enjoyed working with many different small businesses with product management, sales, and digital marketing strategy. And I enjoy meeting new people and learning about their love of their community, says Jennifer. Before we begin the presentation, I'd also like to introduce Janie Maxwell. Janie is the executive director of the Illinois Farmers Market Association. She comes to ILFMA as a lifelong farmers market shopper, a registered dietitian with a background in program management. Janie is passionate about local food and farmers markets and their benefit to market vendors and the community. Janie?
Oh, thank you. Good afternoon, and so glad that you could be with us today. Just going to give a really quick overview and just some highlights about the Illinois Farmers Market Association. I think most of the people on the call today, this is not your first call. You've been participating in the full series of social media webinars, and we're really glad to see that. Today is sponsored by the Illinois Farm Bureau, and we are grateful for their partnership. Just to bring this point home, I just really ask everybody to participate in ILFMA's database, which is with Market Maker for farmers market information. I was just recently at a conference, and to be honest, I'm asked all the time about farmers markets. This time it was by members of the media who were looking for farmers markets to interview about some special features or things that they wanted to highlight. And when farmers markets are not part of our database, it's very difficult for me to, one, find you if I don't know about your existence already, and then refer you if in fact I even know about you, but it's really hard to get your information out to partners that are potentially interested in promoting your market. And I think if you're on this call, you're interested in promoting your market. And so this may be one of the easiest things that you can do is to become part of this database. So again, just to reiterate, the more information that you have within your data profile, the more likely you are to be found. If you have unique things going on about your market, make sure to highlight them. If you meet on multiple days or in different places, consider creating a different profile for each of those markets, because you may have unique vendors on one day that you don't have on another, or maybe you're at a different location. All of that is unique enough that you should make separate profiles for each of those markets. And then we all have an opportunity when we use the search function on our website or the 10 other places where you can access this information across the state from local food partners, then people can find you. And so I just can't tell you enough, especially when, as I said, I was asked about two specific types of markets that I had to do some pretty significant research before I could answer the media requests for those types of markets. And we are in the process of having the What's in Season app updated, but it does have all of that same information. And it's really wonderful, especially for our millennial population that doesn't. We were told when we did some research years ago that if it's not in their phone, it doesn't exist. So we need to make sure your farmer's market is in their phone. Again, we are excited about the Home to Market Act and the changes that it brings to farmers markets. There's another webinar scheduled. If you haven't already signed up and are interested, we are nearing capacity. We have spots for 100 people, and we are nearing that. We are offering our certification program starting in January, and we are really excited about this opportunity to bring together market managers to talk about best practices and to encourage markets to go to their next level of excellence for their community. We ask you to consider supporting the Illinois Farmers Market Association. Farmers Market Association is self-supporting. In most states, it's the land grant institution or the Department of Agriculture that supports the Farmers Market Association, but not in Illinois. We raise all the money that we spend. And so we would ask you to either join or make a donation to ILFMA, especially if this webinar series has been of benefit to you. I think if you were to pay to take a webinar series like this, it would be quite a bit more expensive than the $15 you needed to spend to hold your spot. So if you would consider making a donation to ILFMA, we would really appreciate it. And right now we have our Winter Warmers Cookbook as a thank you, kind of gives you a little bit of the board of directors for ILFMA's interest and passion toward local food and some of their own food history, as well as I think it's 31 recipes that we highly recommend. And if you're not part of the Farmers Market Manager Association on Facebook, we encourage you to join. All right, I'm going to turn it over to Jennifer, and we will get on with social media for farmers markets.
Hi, guys. I'm excited you guys are here. This is probably my favorite topic because it's just so much fun. Let me pull up my notes. I will let you know that Natalie is not here today. So when I go between my phone and computer, there might be a slight delay. So today, here we go. The power of videos and reels. Sorry. We need Natalie for all the tech stuff. Today, we're going to first talk about just the importance of reels and talk about how Instagram is really prioritizing reels on their platform. We're going to look at our smartphones to see how we can use content that you probably already have, images and videos, to create reels. You can also use the same information for TikTok essentially, but this one is just for Instagram. And then at the end, I thought we could make two reels together. So let's first just talk overall about why you should use Instagram Reels. The bottom line is that Instagram and Facebook, they are pushing this medium and they are showing it to people over and over again because they want you to use it. You know, when they first rolled out the Reels, it was really about, you know, TikTok is growing and they wanted to stay kind of competitive with that. And so they came up with their own version of that. I will make one small note here. If you do use both TikTok and Instagram, both platforms really like it if you make the video in their platform. So once in a while, you may see on Instagram a reel and it will have the TikTok logo. Overall, Instagram is probably not going to show those as much. So it does put a little more work for you, but in the end, it would be seen more. So that's kind of one little trick. What is a reel? So I'm kind of just starting basic and then we'll go forward. You may say, I already know this, but we'll talk about it just for a little bit anyway. Similar to TikTok, Instagram created the Reels platform before they had video options and the story option, but this allows you a 15 to 60 second video that you can put to fun music. There are also fun filters, stickers, words. I mean, really think like 13-year-old girl kind of paradise, all the glitter and stickers and all that sort of stuff. I'm not suggesting you use all those, but that it is available there to kind of enhance your reel. Once your reel is made, it you can share it into your story, which we will practice doing today as well. So you kind of get double usage. You can also use your reel again. You could share it in a story maybe a month later if you wanted to. So you can kind of get more use out of the content you're creating. It's also in the Explore feed. So if you personally were to go into Reels in your Instagram account, you just go to Reels and you start scrolling, Instagram is going to start feeding you different Reels. And it's going to be based on what your accounts you follow, things you've liked, stuff like that. So you can kind of get a feel for what other people are doing. But this also means that someone that doesn't like your page already maybe fed your reel, which then leads them to your page and hopefully following your account, because that's really, you know, the ultimate, well, I guess the ultimate is then they actually come to the market. But that would be a way for you to be able to get information out to them. So reach in the Reels tab in the Explore, it's there. You can also, from the profile page on the Reels tab, see all the Reels an account has made. When we post one and when we practice that today, you'll see that on your main grid of your profile, you can have the Reel show up there, or you don't have to. There's different reasons for that. One reason I would say that you wouldn't want it in your grid is if you are particularly curating, I would say, a super specific look on your grid, then the reel may not fit, but it's still there and people can find it. When you're creating a reel, today what I thought we would do is take content you already have and turn it into a reel. There are times you can go on, like you're walking through the market, you can make a reel right there on the spot. I think those are awesome. I think real time reel is definitely beneficial. Today, I'm really showing you how to just to make some catchy ones that you could use now or whenever you see fit. So really that allows you also, if you, let's say you, like me, I was sick last week. If you were sick at the market, but it was the holiday market and you needed to make a reel, you could have someone else video all that information and send it to you, and you could make it at a later date, which is really nice. It doesn't have to be live. Like I said, there's words and stickers and all that fun stuff. You really do get to show your personality. I have different clients that prefer different texts. When they're putting text over their reels, some of them don't like certain fonts, or they only want it to look a certain way. And so really, this is a chance for you to show your personality from your market, from you. I don't stress over that. If you're still looking for that, if you're still trying to figure out all that, just try different things, see what works. That really is, we've talked about this, that's the beauty of digital marketing, is if it's a total flop, you can delete it. If you're just seeing how people engage, you can leave it up there. You're going to grow the more you make, and that's okay. Your reels, you know, starting today are going to be different than in 30 days, 60 days, or 90 days. So when you're making a reel, you can, if you pull up, actually, if everyone wants to go ahead and just open up even your Instagram screen on your phone, you can see if you just go to the main feed, you can, in the top right-hand corner, there's a plus sign. You can hit that, and that will give you the option for post, story, reel. You can also go into your profile and go to the Reels tab. And if you see those, that just means that wherever you're at, you can get in there and make one. So hopefully you'll be able to find that when we make a couple together. I'm just letting everyone find that. All right. Also, like I said, you can do reels one of two ways. Hold the button down and start recording it and making your reel in real time, or you can upload video footage directly from your camera roll. You can create a reel from one video or a series of clips, or just images. And today we're going to really focus on a couple that are made with images, just so you can get the hang of that. It's the same size as a story. So the 9x16, you can also in Canva, I know we talked about that before. In Canva, they now have an Instagram Reels editing tool, and it's really awesome. The only thing I would say is when we look at some tutorials here in a minute, the seconds in Canva are by the 10th of the second, and sometimes that's not exact. So it's not always beneficial to use that, but it does allow you to, if you're more, if you like to look at your computer and use a computer screen to put things together, that also might be a good way to start. Reels, they can actually go up to 60 seconds, and also that they're only on the mobile device. So also think about that. You know, it's not a movie where you would need, you know, lots of dialogue and it to be super smooth. It's really mobile and people are scrolling. And I think I said it in another one, but we're kind of around the 8 seconds is the average attention span. So it has to be catchy. It's fast. I know I make reels for a lot of clients, and I do think generationally even my husband is always like, well, I was so fast. Like, I don't even know what they're talking about. Now he's not on social media. So, he gets what TikTok is and what reels are, but just the idea that it's a different medium and you have to think about it in a different space that, you know, if we're used to seeing commercials or the news where something is more polished and finished start to end, got to kind of not think that way. Got to think more flashy, fast, grab their attention. You know, we want them to hit the heart button. We want them to like it. We want them to go to our account to learn more, but it's just more of a snippet, a sneak into something, a sneak into your market or behind the scenes to allow people to want more. So I think that's one thing when you're making it to really think about it. It's not just a video of information. I put all of these really side-by-side instructions down for people that we're going to do this together, but if you want to come back, I know they send you the link that you can screenshot this and put it next to you. So if when we're done here, you kind of say, I don't even remember what she said. I know that she added music, but I don't know where it was. This is really for you to screenshot, put it somewhere if you want it. And I think you're going to be a pro here in a little bit. So you won't even need this, but this is a way just to kind of remember step by step what we're going to do. Okay, so now this is really the fun part. And I don't know, and I did not ask Janie this at the beginning, but I'm hoping that perhaps we, you know, take little breaks here and you guys can share some of these at the end, like the ones you made, just so you can kind of get a kind of look at to see what other people are doing. These are two screenshots of tutorials. So here's what's really awesome. When Reels first came out, this didn't exist because people hadn't started making the tutorials. But I'm going to switch to my phone here in a second. But when you follow accounts that have tutorials, this for someone maybe that isn't really into Reels, you're not personally going to be scanning them to see what is, you know, the trending sounds and stuff. These make your life so much easier because they take trending sounds and they literally break it down. The one on the left here, the purple one, is the one we're going to make first. It literally, what that means, if you look at that, that means the first image is 1.85 seconds or video. And if you go on, you'll see 0.29, 0.27, and there's two of those at that. That literally breaks it down and tells you how to set it with the music. Instagram has a new feature that sometimes it will say, do you want me to set your photos to the correct music? I think you can try that. I have not had a lot of luck with it actually working the way I want it to. So I usually, if there's a trending song and there's a tutorial, then I go ahead and I actually do that. So what I would suggest doing is, I'm hoping you have your phone separate. The one on the left is the one we're going to do first. So kind of keep that in mind. And I'm going to switch to my phone right now. So hold on just a second. Okay, can you guys hear me? Give me a thumbs up over there in the chat. I just want to make sure you can hear me.
We're good.
Okay, awesome. Here we go. All right, I'm going to go. There's my family at Brookfield Zoo. Sorry. Here we go. Here's my pretend account that we made at a different class, just to kind of give you an example and not using a real account. So the first thing is I'm going to go to the feed, like if you would have opened it up. And I remember followed a few markets just to kind of get the idea. Like I said, at the top right-hand corner at the plus sign, it gives you the option to do a post, a story, a reel, or go live. So right there, that's one way you can do a reel. Also, from your main profile page, the plus sign is up there as well. It gives you those options, plus the story highlight button, which we talked about in the first or second class. Now, if you opened up your Instagram or your market's Instagram, you will see in the bottom middle, it has a play button on it, and that's the reel thing. I just wanna make sure this isn't gonna blast you guys out because these can be loud. So if we hit the reel button, this is in the explore option, which means these markets that I followed, if they had reels, they're going to show up in it. But it also means that I'm probably going to see some other things. So if we hit the reel button,
tell me how did you get so enough to chill my bones? Tell me how did you get so enough to
tutorials.
I could be red, or I could be yellow, I could be blue.
I will stand in the corner. I'm going to turn that off just for a second. What this also allows you to do, I'm going to go back in it. I just don't know if the sound gets messed up when I'm in there as well. Can you guys hear me talking even when the music of the reels was going?
Yes, but it was a little bit hard to hear you. But we could.
Oh, okay. Okay. I'm going to go back into the reel. Turn off the sound in there for a moment. I think that is okay. There we go. In the bottom right-hand corner, if you see the music note, if you hit that, that shows you the sound that's being used. It shows you how many reels have used this sound. And it also allows you to save the audio. Now, there's two ways to help you find songs that you like. If you see people using the same song over and over again, you can go in, this was the song. Okay, I'm gonna like this song. And then I'm gonna save the audio. And you can come back at another time. When you're starting out, what I would suggest, I'm gonna go back. Did the share stop?
Yes, it did.
Sorry, guys. Hold on. Okay. Another thing, if you have a tutorial, one that you like the song and you like the instructions, if you go to the three dots, you're going to just save it. So I'm going to show you where you can go find all those saved reels to help you build your own. I would even suggest if you, 5 minutes scrolling, find, a few that you like just to get you started. We're going to go to this, my fake account here. I made a reel. I am going to turn up the sound so you can see it. And this is the one that was on the other screen in purple with the instructions of how many seconds. So
let's hold on. I am going to turn up the sound so you can hear it. And then this is the one we're actually going to build. As you see also in the profile, this is where your profile images would be in your grid. And then in the middle, there's your reels. So here we go.
24/7, I'm thinking about you. 24/7, I'm thinking about you. Yeah. 24/7, I'm thinking about you. 24/7, I'm thinking about you.
Okay, so that one, I picked a song that had a tutorial that was kind of trending, and I decided to make it about the market. The song, it says 24/7, I'm thinking about you. And so I just kind of made that into, you know, focusing on the market. So let me pull up, hold on 1 second. I'm gonna stop this share because I want everyone to write this down. Okay, everyone go ahead and take either a screenshot or a pen and paper. And this on the left-hand side, let me blow it up here. On the left-hand side, right, let's get a piece of paper or take a screenshot and let's go ahead and write down those numbers. So on the left-hand side, write down 1.85, then 0.29, and then 0.27, 0.27. Go ahead and write those down on a scratch piece of paper, and then we're gonna go build this one together. Okay. Did everyone get that? Maybe. Okay. I'm going to go back to my phone. All right, is everyone with me? Say hey on the chat. Okay, awesome. So we're gonna go back into Instagram. And actually, this is what I'm gonna also need you guys to do. The song that, you see this song, 24/7. In your search bar, oh, it keeps kicking me out, guys. In your search bar, down here at the bottom in the search, put 24/7, hit search, and audio. And it's the first one on my list. See if you can find that one. You're going to click on it. That's because my account is like fake. So when you get to that sound, hold on, sorry. When you get to that sound, you're going to hit save. Abby, what's your Instagram handle? And I will just send you the sound. If anyone's having trouble with that, I'll just message you the sound and you can save it that way. Does anyone else need the sound? Okay, if you've saved the sound, at the bottom you can hit use audio. So automatically, I guess I'll do it this way, automatically that puts the song right up in the corner. It knows that you are using that song, so you're not going to have to go back to that. So the song is there, you've said you want to use it, and you know all of your times that you needed because you've written it down. I literally will find usually a piece of scratch paper and I write it down. I kind of just scratch, okay, these are the times for the photos I need. Once you are on this screen, in the left-hand bottom where your camera roll is, you're able to access your images that you want to build this. So the first image I chose when I made the original one to use a video. So I get down into my camera roll and I'm going to scroll. And if you just have an image, that is fine too. I think I had some videos here. So here's a video. When you add this video, now remember the reel said 1.85 seconds for the first thing. So these at the bottom, the toggle allows you to change how long the clip is. So when we go down to 1.85, I can do that with while I'm holding this. You can get to 1.85. And then at the top right-hand corner, you're going to hit add. Okay, so that's the first one. So you can kind of mark that off on your list. Is everyone with me so far? I'm looking at my chat. I'm going to keep going and then just message if there's issues. Okay, so then down in the bottom, I'm going to hit the camera again. Here's all my lovely photos from the farmer's market. It's 0.29. I'm just going to pick one. Same thing at the bottom. I'm going to go down to 0.29. And I'm going to add it. Okay. People going. I'm going to keep doing this. I'm going to go through the list. I'll do it slowly together. Then at the end, I'm going to show you how to add all like the fun stuff. Okay. So now I did on my list, I'm crossing off 1.85, crossing off 0.29. Now I know the next two are 0.27. So let's go get them. Add it, do it again. And you guys can be doing this with your own pictures, obviously. Then I mark those off. I like to keep track. 0.24 is the next one. Point 0.38. As you can see, even it's hard to always get it right on there. At 0.38. Now there's a 0.68. And you can also intermingle maybe the 0.68. I want to do another video. So you can, you know, put in something else. So 0.68. I'm going to add that. 0.26. Point two. Point 21. Point 0.24. And you guys can go at your own pace. Point 0.51. And then the last one is 0.36. I chose and the one I did too, this one as my last one because it had space at the top to add some information with writing that would be legible. So the last one was 0.36. Okay, I'm going to wait just a few minutes, anyone want to make in the comments? Are you guys trying it or are you just watching me try it? Okay. I'm going to give you one more minute. Once you get to this part, you did your tutorial, you added your information. Before it's done, before anything, you can always go and preview it. So I'm going to hit preview and the sound will probably be on at that point. Sorry. Sorry, I think that it is not wanting to share that. Hold on. Hold on just a second.
I'm coming back on this one just to check on you guys. I'm going to make it, it doesn't want to share that. So is anyone also trying it just to know? Okay, good. I don't know why it's... Okay. Okay, I don't know why it's not wanting to share that. So, or it's not letting me share the preview with you. I'm gonna go back to my phone.
Okay, here we are, back on here. Everyone with me? I think so. So you guys, did everyone add all those? Everyone at the same spot? I don't know why it's not going to let me show you the preview of this. So that is unfortunate, but that's okay. I'm going to make another screen to show you how to add different words on it. Okay, so you've added all of your images or videos timed to that tutorial that we did. When you go into preview, hold on one more second, I'm gonna add. You're gonna go into preview and you see this at the top where it says the letters. If you hit that, just like a story, you have all your options for text and you can do all funny things with it. So let's just say we love the farmer's market. And just like stories, you can make it bigger, smaller, whatever you want to do with your text. You can change colors. I mean, that you can play around with, and you can put that right there at the top. At the bottom, at the bottom, when you hit the text, that is that exact same text, the toggle then at the bottom becomes where you will see the text. So if you just want the text on this image, you toggle at the bottom after you've clicked the text, and you can toggle. So in between the two lines is where the text will show. You see, if I broaden it, you see how the text is up at the top. And so if it was all the way across, your text would be all the way across every single image and video. But to get the wording to change, you can make it on whichever ones you want. Now, same with, you hit done, if you hit the sticker button, if we put in farmer's market, here's some lovely stickers. I'm going to use the strawberries. So if we had the strawberries, can kind of move the size. If you click on the strawberries at the bottom, you can say, you know, I just really wanted those on the last one. and then they'll only show up on that one. Does that make sense so far? I'm thinking yes. So I'm going to go back and show you the version of the reel that went with this tutorial. And I want you guys to see how the writing disappears and comes back. So let's go find. So watch for the writing and the stickers. Here we go.
Okay, I'm coming back over here just because I am having trouble. Were you guys able to hear the music on that? Because it feels like it, on my end, it's not wanting to share the music. Anybody?
No, we weren't able to hear the music.
Okay. Can you guys hear the music on your own devices then, like when you're making it? Yes, you can. Okay. Out of everyone who's, you could when you're making it. Awesome. That's great. Nicole, would you be willing to share it? Did you just make it? Can we, I would love to see it. Or if you don't want to share, it's okay. Okay, you're totally fine. You're not behind. You keep going. I do want to show you one more thing. And I don't know why. I don't know if it doesn't like that we're sharing it. I'm not really sure why, but I'm going to go in and I'm going to show you how, once you do have a completed reel, how to share it to a story. So we're going to do that.
Okay. We need Natalie. Here we go. I'm going to share this again. Okay. So let's say you have. Thinking about you. Yeah. 24/7. I'm thinking about you. 24/7. I'm thinking about you. Yours will look probably a little bit different. You can send it to another, you know, friend or business, but you can add it to your story. So when you add it to your story, it comes up in a smaller screen than the story size. So I kind of like to, you know, maybe even add text once you've shared it in your story. You can take the write-in and say, you know, see you Saturday from 7 to noon. That's our market. That's what I'll say. You know, and you can add that just like the stories. Sometimes the text gets funny, so you can, you know, move it around and do that. And so then when you share it to your story, you know, up here your story would show for other people. So then it's in your story. 24/7, I'm thinking about you. 24/7, I'm thinking about you. Yeah. Does that make sense? Yeah, that would be great, Nicole. This, what is this account? There it is. You can send it to this one if you want. Oh, okay. Take your time. Now, you guys are either staring at your screens thinking,
I hate this, or you are maybe thinking, this is dumb. I don't know. Maybe you love it. Maybe you think this is the best thing ever. This is what I know. They don't have to be fancy. I think the tutorials are really helpful because they allow you to have someone else tell you the seconds to put in it. You can also skip forward if you are like, I don't want a reel that has 20 images. I have 5 images and that's all I want. Great. Then, you know, you can do that too. I want to show you guys one I made. This is somewhat of a trending song right now. This one I made, I'm going to show you. And this one was made not with a tutorial, but you're going to hear, I'm going to find it. Sorry. You're going to hear where the music changes. I was able to use the toggle at the bottom to make it, fit with the music. So, okay, here it is. I'm going to show you this one while Nicole sends us hers. Here we go. And listen, watch this one to be, it fits with the music. It was not a tutorial. And once you hear it, you're going to know what I mean. Because if you find a song you like, if there's a holiday song you like, it doesn't have to be planned out by these seconds, but I think this is a great place to start. So here we go.
Can we skip to the good part? If there's a good part, then I hope it's not far cut.
Okay, so that one I wanted to show because that one is a really good example of, I'm gonna just look at you guys instead. That one is really good because that one allowed me to toggle where the music changed. And so it doesn't always have to be so pre-programmed. And oh, yay, Nicole sent us one. I'm glad to see hers. Okay, we're gonna go look at hers. And they're all great. Like, that's the fun part. You make it your own. Like, you're not going to mess it up. You can't mess it up. Uh-oh. Let's see. Uh-oh, Nicole. What do you think? Maybe I should try again. Are there any other questions about different ways to use the reels? If there's a way, okay, thanks, Nicole. If everyone wants to also, before we get off of here, what I'd like to do, because I was afraid this would happen, the time gets really far away from us. What I'd like to do, in case you have trouble finding the sounds, if everyone can put your handle in the chat, what I will do is I will send you, let's just do like 3. I'll send you 3 sounds and 3 tutorials that go with the sounds. So when you go from here, you don't have to like start searching to try to find those. I'm just going to give 3 of those to you and I'll just send them to your account so you can practice that way, because really it's about practice and just doing it over and over again. So, we will definitely, that's what I'll do. I'll just send those out to make sure that you guys have those. And Nicole just sent this. So let's go see if we can see that. I'm excited, Nicole. Okay, here we go. I'm excited.
24/7, I'm thinking about you. 24/7, I'm 24/7, I'm thinking about you. 24/7, I'm 24/7, I'm thinking about you. 24/7, I'm 24/7.
Everyone, give a big clap for Nicole.
Okay, I'm going to come back on here because I know that we definitely are getting to the end. So here's the deal. You can Google how to do reels. You're going to find lots of information, but I really want to say you have the content. It is beautiful. It's amazing. It's real. It's people at the market. You know, it's your vendors. It's the produce. You know, that's why people go to your market in the first place, because they love you guys. They love the people that come. They love the atmosphere. And this allows you to just highlight it in a different way. There are going to be tons of trending songs. There's always going to be things you can look into, but the idea is to really have fun with reels. I don't think you need to do a reel every day. If that's what you do and you start becoming a pro at it, that is awesome. And I would love to see them. But the idea is it's a different way to highlight your everything you do in an elevated way, because we know Instagram is going to show it. So I will, after we get off here, I'm going to just take everyone's handles and I will send you 3 tutorials with sound so you can start working on those. There are a lot of, I've noticed lately, trending sounds like holiday sounds, whether it be Christmas, you know, I don't know if I saw a Jingle Bells one. There's one, a Nick Jonas Christmas song that seems to be trending. Those don't have tutorials. But if you have a holiday market and you want to kind of just go through it and put it with that music, awesome. Put maybe a Santa on there. I don't know. But the idea is to make it fun with the content you have, that the more you do, I just think the more you'll enjoy it and the better you'll get at it. Also, one other thing, you're going to make a reel and it's going to be viewed 5,000 times. And you're going to be like, yes, that's amazing. And the next reel you make is going to be viewed 100 times. I don't have an answer why, but don't let that be discouraging. Also, I've made reels 8 months ago, and for some reason it gets picked back up into the Discover reel and it's being viewed later down the road. So don't be discouraged by that. Just keep making them. Just like with the post, just keep posting, use your stories. And the more you do it, it'll be just a part of your natural day and promoting of the market. So I want to make sure that I have all of these and I will send these when we get off.
Thank you, Jennifer. That was really amazing. Really appreciate your help with this.
This one's a hard one. And this is why I wish we were all in a room together, because we could, you know, kind of huddle together and do hands-on. But
well, thank you, Jennifer. And I'd like to thank everyone else for attending today. In the chat box, if you had any questions before we go,